you got superpowers. Turn my minutes into hours. You got more than 2020, babe. Made of glass, the way you see through me. So this is the look we did today. Thank you guys so much for even clicking on this video. Make sure you please like and subscribe. And if you're really looking at these lashes and you loving them, then stay tuned for all the information and all the tea I'ma give at the end of the video. Okay, okay. Without further ado, let's get to it. Yeah, I beat my face, moving fast, cause I'm Uber on the way. Taking pictures, make sure you can see no less. That wig secure like the money in a safe. I look like bae, now I'm on the way. Let you know when I'm about a mile away. When I'm outside, please don't make me wait. The party's starting when we pull up to the gate. Today is going to be a very chill video. We're going to do a full face today. I mean, my eyebrows are already done, but yeah. Because, anyway, let's move on. So we're going to start off with the P. Louise base. This is in the shade Remore 02. And I'm just going to put that on the back of my hand. Just like a tiny, tiny bit. Like that much. I've taken this very dirty palette. I could have cleaned it before I showed it in the video, but I don't feel like doing that.
Whoa, calm down, Jamal. Don't pull out the 9.
This is the 5303 Morphe palette. It looks like this. It's very, very beautiful. And I feel like we're going to be using this palette and the Morphe 3502 palette, which looks like this. Very beat up, very not cute. I have an eyelash on it. I don't know how this occurs. But clearly I'm careless with my makeup. Anyway, first shade we're going to be taking is this orangey kind of burnt shade, and this is going to be our transition shade. I don't know if I'm doing this correctly, but I hope this turns out pretty. And I'm just going to use padding motions to like kind of blend it out. I'm saying I don't want to bring it over here. I kind of want to leave that like eyeshadow free for a little bit. I don't know what I'm really going for. Brown shade right here. I'm really just winging it. I don't even know what I'm doing, what I'm trying to achieve. I don't know. I'm just doing whatever. I just did my off camera because I didn't know what I was doing and I was just having a hard time. Like, I don't know. I'm gonna take this dark brown color right here. Can you see it? Yeah. That color, and we're just going to apply that into our crease. And yeah. Now I'm gonna be taking this really light shade right here, and I'm just going to tap that right on top of this area. I just wanted to stop the video real quick to tell you that I forgot to freaking start my camera when I did my wing eyeliner, and I'm sorry about that, but it's just a very simple liner. Okay, we are done with the eyeshadow for now, and it's time to move on to the face. The first product I'm going to be using is the Milk Makeup Blur Stick, and I never really used this before, so we're about to see how this drawing works for real. Oh no, it's supposed to like blur. I don't know, make your face look blurry or whatever. I don't. All right, so now we're gonna move on to foundation. This foundation that I'm using is very affordable. I feel like you guys should really invest in this foundation. It's a really, really good foundation. Like, it is so good. It's so full coverage, and I just love it. This is like a OG foundation. Like, this is when I first started out doing makeup and all that good stuff. It's just really, really good. It's full coverage. Oh, I didn't even say what it's called. It's called Maybelline. Is there a name? I think it's called Super Stay, or like Stay All Day. Like, it, the name is on the top, it's not on the bottle. But yeah, next I'm gonna be taking my Juvia's Place
concealer. Oh my gosh. I was not expecting all that wetness. That didn't sound right. But it's super. I don't know. I haven't used this in a while, so I forgot how it felt. I like this big brush. It like reminds me of the Tarte Shape Tape. Is it Tarte? Or the Too Faced? I think it's Tarte. This NYX concealer, I'm using it as a contour. In the shade Cappuccino, so I don't know, it's very, very light. Not like, I use it as a contour, so like for contour it's pretty light, because I don't know, I'm trying to focus my contour to be very, I don't know, I just want my contour to be softer and stuff. Now I am taking my Fenty Beauty setting powder in the shade Honey, and I'm just going to set everywhere that I concealed. Let's get back to the video. Now I'm taking my Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette, and I'm just going to basically set where I cream contoured. Okay, so now we're about to move back to the eyes. I'm just going to take this, this brown shade right there, and I'm just going to tap that right underneath my eyeball, like so. Now I really want to smoke it out, so like don't be afraid to like, I did not mean to put it in that sheet. Don't be afraid to like smoke it out, because I want this to be like really smoky and dramatic. Next, I'm going to take that dark brown shade that we put in our crease, and I'm just going to move that closer to the eye. I'm not going to smoke that one out as much. Okay, so I went ahead and did my lips off camera, because I don't know if you see my last videos, but I don't usually do my lips on camera, because I don't know, it's so cringy to me and I just don't like it. But I'm gonna be taking my Too Faced blush. It's like a gel, kind of like it's not powder, it's like, I don't know how to, I think it says it on the back. Oh, it says melting powder, but this is not powder. This is like, I don't freaking know. But it's a really pretty blush. It's buildable. It's supposed to be like subtle and cute, delicate, like that. But I like to really add a lot of blush. So yeah, it's so pretty. I put some on my nose. It smells so good. Everything by Too Faced smells like heaven. Now I'm gonna be taking my new favorite highlighter by Anastasia Beverly Hills. It is her loose powder highlighter. This one is in the shade So Holiday. It's just called So Holiday. And then I'm gonna take this, and I'm just going to tap it on my cheeks. Like, do you see why I love this highlighter? Like, oh my gosh, like holy crap, it's so good. Like, it's amazing. Like, I just add a highlight to my nose and then underneath my brow bone. And now I'm just going to set my face with the Vel setting spray. Now it's time for the moment I have been waiting for. I am going to be showing you guys these amazing, amazing lashes. These are Wink For You lashes, and I really want to get into the packaging. It is So super cute. She puts her card in there with all of her information. And she also, she gives you this little note. Like, it's basically instructions. There we go. I got the word out. Anyway, she gives you this. Like, she basically tells you how to, like, properly take care. And she tells you, like, what kind of lashes they are. And she gave me 3 lashes. These are super, super cute. Like, look at it. It comes with the cutest packaging. I wish I had a good camera so you can actually really see. But it's, like, this holographic print. It's in this pink box. I wish I could talk. Oh my gosh. It says Wink for You Lashes, which is so cute. It's 3D Lashes by Kimberly. That's her name, Kimberly. So is there names? Oh yeah, there's names on them. Okay. So this one is called Miss Kimberly. These are very, very wispy, and I love wispy. This one is more on the natural side, which I'm trying to get into, like, natural looking lashes, because the big thick lashes aren't hitting the same. Like, I'm also on the natural side, which I'm here for. I'm loving, because, like, I'm really trying to get into, like, natural looking lashes, because, like I said, like, the thick ones are just not doing it for me anymore, you know? Like, do y'all know? Are y'all feeling me? But anyway, this one is called Georgia Peach. This is super cute. Now, let's get into my favorite ones. These are my favorite ones so far. These aren't really on the natural side, but let's get into these ones. These are the ones I'm going to be putting. These ones are called Atlanta. These are the ones I'm going to be popping on my eyes. Anyways, these are very, very, I wouldn't say they're very dramatic. Like, they're just the right amount. Like, they're just the right amount. They're super cute, super wispy, very full. And I'm going to be putting these ones on. And, you know, Atlanta's where it be popping. So she had to make her most popping dramatic lashes Atlanta. All right, so this is what it looks like. And I love that they're curved like that. And so formed, because, like, it's going to make it 10 times easier to apply your lash. Like, it's not flimsy, like, it's easy to work with. Like, you can literally just pop these on, and I'm going to show y'all how I'm about to just pop these babies on my eyelash. Very easy application, which I love. That is why I love a firm lash, like one that's curved like that. Oh my god, look at how pretty these are. Okay guys, this is the finished look of the look. I really love the eyes. They're very seductive, like very, ooh, I'm about to take your man. Like, oh my god, especially the lashes, like, don't touch me. But anyway, I love these lashes. I love the look. It all came together. I was a little worried because I was like, oh my god, like, this is not coming out how I wanted to, but it worked out kind of. I think it's cute. I like the look. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. The link for these lashes will be in the description box, so don't forget to check the description box. And why are they running around upstairs like that? Oh my god, please ignore that. But yeah, it's gonna be in the description box. My social medias will be in the description box, and I'm also gonna have them pop up on screen. I'm also gonna have her Instagram IG name pop up on screen, and that's also gonna be listed down below. That was a lot to say.